Chekhov. I mean, Billy. Come along.
Yes, sir.
Billy, please don't even go near him.
I've gone through this in my head over and over, and it's changed over the years, but the favorite episode in which I appeared was Spectre of the Gun.
You shouldn't have come back to town, Billy. Morgan will kill you because he wants me.
With his outdated weapon. If he shoots at me, I will just step out of the way.
Chekhov gets to kiss the girl. He gets shot. He dies. He comes back.
Captain, I don't understand.
Neither do I. He's in perfect health.
And beyond that, this is one of those cases where necessity, being the mother of invention, we had a highly stylized show. Because our budget was particularly short on this particular episode, and I don't know the reason why offhand. And rather than trying to conceal the fact that we were only using storefronts, we were using facades, they integrated that into this show.
Obviously, this represents the Melkoshian's concept of an American frontier town, circa 1880.
It's just bits and pieces. It's incomplete.
And it gave it a very eerie, otherworldly sense. And I thought that the show stood out because of that stylized approach that they used.
The episode was Spectre of the Gun, and I played Wyatt Earp.
It was a strange situation because Rex Holman and Charlie Maxwell and I were hired to be the three Earp boys.
Take my bag.
And then Sam Gilman was hired to be Doc Holliday. When we read the script, at least speaking for myself, it really looked like somewhat of a dud. And when we showed up on the set and saw the stylized buildings and so on and so forth, it seemed to be even more of a dud. And the director, Vince McAviti, who was a very nice guy, he would juxtapose our positions, you know, and it was all part of the design of the show to make it more of a surrealistic fantasy kind of thing, you know, where in one cut we were walking a certain way in terms of our relationship to each other, and then the next cut, for no reason at all, we were completely reversed, which didn't make a lot of sense to us, but made a lot of sense to him, and he was right. Because the show, in a very strange way, turned out to be one of the, the classic Star Trek. It seemed to me that there was something very life-affirming and very positive about Star Trek. I think it touched a lot of people because it wasn't just the fact that Bill and Leonard and Scotty and so on and so forth were overcoming adversity.
We come in peace. But we'll defend ourselves if necessary.
They were dealing with rather esoteric problems that people could sort of strange things that people could sort of hang their hats on, and they could sort of live, empathize with what the characters were doing. I mean, if you look at some of the stories, they weren't the common kind of story. They were very special.
I wonder how humanity managed to survive.
We overcame our instinct for violence.
Each show is a morality play of its own. Within this kind of high-tech framework.
Evil does seek to maintain power by suppressing the truth
or by misleading the innocent.
It's just one of those strange chemistry things, and it happened. And I was very fortunate to be part of it.